Hey everyone, this is Victor from Growth Evolution Development Ground, GEDground.com. In today's video, I want to share with you something that I've decided on this year, this 2017. It's a New Year resolution. And the decision was to start a new online business. And the thing is that I can be also considered as a newbie. I have already an online business in publishing, but it's not very difficult, and I've already talked about it in one of my previous videos, which I'll link below. And it was a great way to get into an online business and to learn about selling things online. And I've decided that I want to move on and do something of a bigger scale. So I thought it'd be pretty interesting to record and make blogs on this topic and just share my experience as a person who has no clue in what he's going to go through. And I'm just going to talk about a little bit what kind of online businesses can we choose from, the mindset a little bit, and so on, and just share with you. So if you're also interested, you can hop on aboard and get through this journey with me. And so the decision was basically, it was like a New Year resolution. And the thing is that I've decided, or I haven't even decided, but I've just noticed that I'm bored. Sure, I can work, I can have one, small online business, but it's not exciting enough. And I know that many people are like me also, if they're not doing anything, if they're not growing, evolving, they get really bored of life, and some people may turn to drugs, alcohol, or video games. Doesn't matter, but it's pretty common. And so to keep myself engaged and excited, I've decided to start a new online business. And I think that this is going to be difficult, this is going to be interesting, and this is something definitely that's going to keep me excited for a long period of time. And who knows, I may enjoy the process a lot more than I even expected. So, yeah, like I said, I thought it would be pretty interesting to record this and to share my experience, but also to, for myself, so I can keep myself accountable. And I've already previously talked about this. There's no better way to be accountable for things than to, write them down. And even more accountable if you're actually filming it and letting other people see it. So this really... I really make sure that I'm not going to slack around by doing this. And also the topic is pretty interesting. So, okay, now about the decision itself. So an online business, right? Why not a normal business? Well, normal business, that means you're going to be, you're going to have to stick to some place, right? You're going to have to probably hire real workers and get a place to work at, and it's going to have a lot of expenses, and the success rate in startups is also very low, so the chances are that it's going to fail, they're pretty big. And if you fail in an online business, the losses are not so big, because you don't have, most likely in the beginning, any workers, people working for you, and you don't have a physical place except, well, your home and your laptop that you're actually working at. So an online business is a really great opportunity, and there are many different types of things you can do, right? Seriously, like, if you Google, there's so many things to choose from, and this makes it even more exciting. And I know so many people, especially the older generations, that think that, oh, you cannot really make any serious money through the internet. Well, the reality of things today in 2016 and 2017 is that you can. You just have to be really creative, and there's so many ways to do it. If you have some kind of a hobby, for example, and you're really good at something, you can monetize. You can even make, basically just as simple as, YouTube videos and share it with people. And, if you start getting the views, you'll get some sort of income. Or you can, you can become an online coach. There is all kind of online coaching businesses involved today. Some of them are pretty funny, though, because, they're... online trainers. I think it's pretty hard for a person to train, in the gym based on online coaching, because I think your coach needs to be there with you to show you how it's done, in order for you not to hurt yourself, especially in places like the gym. But regardless of that, you can do online coaching, and I mean, like playing a new instrument, you can teach people like that. So, like I said, you just have to be creative. And if you know, if you feel that you know something better than others, like you have some hobby, you can really go into that. So, also you can, for example, make a, you know, a digital product. You don't have to coach only. If you, many people that are good at something, they know something more than others, and they feel like sharing with the world, they don't have to, you know, coach one person at a time. They can make a digital product and allow people to buy it. And, you know, this way you're basically creating passive income. You're just sitting, you've made the product once, people are constantly buying it if it's a good product. And, yeah, you're generating income. And like I said, this is a good way if you don't want to, you know, do the repetitive process of coaching everybody one by one. And this is really popular these days. There are so many digital products online, you know, thousands and thousands. Some are crappy, some are good. It's just about finding the right one and also putting your time and effort to really make a good one. And also what's really cool about it is that you're not spending almost any money on creating a digital product, and your profit is like almost 100%, right? Because you're you know, you haven't spent anything and you're getting all this money from you know, from people buying this product. But again, if you think that this is for you but you don't know anything, don't bother. You know, I'm really into, like, I think it's good to make a product like that if you really know what you're talking about, because so many people, they're not sure, they're kind of like learning as they're doing the product. I've seen these kind of things also, and I don't think this is good. You're not going to get any positive feedback from that or big money. You're probably just going to spend some time, you know, doing it and no income from it. And then there's also affiliate marketing, for example. That's when you promote other people's products, and when another person buys this product, you earn some kind of a commission. And this is really cool because you don't have to create any product yourself. All you're doing is just basically telling other people that, hey, there's this product, you know, it's really cool, and you know, you're just getting a commission for it. And I think this is like a good situation because there are people who are trying to get their products out there, and you know, they're maybe not enough people find it, and you're helping other people find these products. So you're helping, you know, the people who have created this product to generate more income, but you're also helping people actually find this product. Maybe somebody would need this, but they don't even know about this thing. And then you tell them that this thing exists, and you know, you're helping them out as well, especially if it's a good product and, you know, they're both satisfied, these two parties. And finally, you're helping yourself because you're getting a commission from it. This is a really cool way of earning money, but for this you need some kind of a following. You need to be able to contact people, you know, to find people that are interested in certain topics and, you know, directed at them. So if you have no social following on online or like a website or anything, then you would need to first create one, right? And then finally, you can sell things also online, and this is what I'm heading towards. I'm, like I said, I have already a publishing business online, and as much as I think it's a great way to begin begin an online business, you know, learn all the tips and tricks, because you know, when you go into selling, you know nothing about it. So the easier it is, the better in the beginning, right? So, and like I said, publishing online, like Kindle, is very newbie friendly, so it's a great way to get into something. But once you've gotten into it, and like I feel right now, and I already know, you know, sufficiently about it, I feel like I want to try myself in something bigger. And also because, you know, it's not my passion. Publishing business is nice, it brings some money, it can bring a lot of money if you put more time into it, but you know, I don't feel like I'm very passionate about it. So I've decided to go for Amazon and try their FBA business, which is basically fulfillment by Amazon. There's also eBay, but I'm gonna stick to Amazon, at least in the beginning. That's what I've decided. And like I said, it's about selling products. And in the beginning, you know, I'm going to try, you know, finding some small products, some really simple ones, and just see how it goes, because it's going to be a whole new type of business. And I want to learn all the, you know, things that I can before wasting a lot of money and maybe having losses, right? And then, of course, my goal is, it would be nice to actually create some product that, you know, would be very, very interesting for me. That's something that I'd be passionate about, you know, something really different from everyone, from everything out there. And, you know, like I said, that a product that I'm passionate about and that could definitely help people. This is the ultimate goal in the end. But in the beginning, like I said, to keep it simple, just simple products. So yeah, FBA business. And why Amazon? Well, the thing is that Amazon is great, right? They have these, like with publishing, they have an on-demand basically service, which means that you don't need to create books beforehand. You don't need to, you know, pay for storage, for the warehouse area. All you do is you create it in a digital form, and when somebody is interested, they buy it, and then Amazon goes and prints it on demand, so only when it's needed. And this eliminates all the costs for all the storage and all the keeping, right? So Amazon has this thing with publishing, which is amazing, and they also have this FBA business, which is also really cool, although a little different from publishing, because here you have physical products, right? And you can't, like, if you're selling, I don't know, pillows, you can't print pillows on demand, right? But what you do is you find the pillows, you create the pillows, or you ask somebody else to create them, like in a factory, and then you can send it over to Amazon, or ask the factory to send it directly to Amazon, and they keep it for you there, and they handle all the requests. So when people buying, they handle it, and they ship the things when needed, and then they also handle the returns in case there are, which is really cool because you don't have to do any of that. Think about it. If you have your own store, you have to, you know, keep up the store, you have to market, because, you know, how are people going to find your store and your products, right? And Amazon, all the people are there already. They have all their, you know, they come there to buy things, and there's a huge amount of people, like millions of people go there all the time online to buy products. So it's really cool because you're using their platform. And at the same time, you don't have to worry about, other than creating the product and getting it to Amazon, you don't have to worry about anything else. You know, customer service, shipping back and forth, handling, you know, returns. All these things are very, very demanding. And that's what people have been doing for, you know, for the last hundred years. And they've been creating stores, physical ones, and actually, you know, they have to stick and be in the store and handle, you know, help the people that come there and handle all the requests and, you know, get the your goods back and forth. So all of these things are eliminated with Amazon. And I've decided that this is going to be a really cool, I can, you know, this is something I can do besides real work, right? Because I'll handle this, I'll get all the goods, and then, you know, it's going to be kind of like passively working. So I can keep on doing other things while it's still making me money, which is pretty cool. I mean, I'm not expecting to go make a lot of money in the beginning, but like I said, I feel bored, and this is one way to keep me excited. I want to try out something new, see where this can take me. Maybe in a year I won't be doing this anymore. Who knows? Maybe I'll do something else, or I won't like it. Who knows? But like at the moment, in the new year, I made this decision, and now I'm excited about it, and I'm really looking forward. Now, how am I going to go into this? And I'm definitely going to get an online course to learn about FBA. Like I said, I don't know anything about this at the moment. I'm a newbie. I've been watching some videos, listening to podcasts here and there about this topic, and, you know, I know very little. And before, people would just go into a new business and make a bunch of errors and mistakes and fail, maybe. And, well, actually, most likely. Now, you have, like I said, digital products, courses that can help us out. And I've already purchased courses in the past, and I'm very addicted to them now because they're very, very helpful. Because when you pay for something like a course, you're paying for, well, if you've done the research, you're paying for a high quality product. You're getting all the information regarding some topic all structured out and laid out for you in a coherent manner. You can actually follow step by step and get things right, and this way you're going to minimize the errors that you can get. Obviously, the story is different for everyone. We all make mistakes, everybody has their own path, but there are general things that we should do that if you're new, you won't know of simply. But with these courses, you get all this help. You get all this help from the people that have created this course and have gone through the path themselves. So I, like I said, I've bought courses in the past, and I think they're very useful, and it would be silly to go into something new and basically think that, oh, I'm gonna, do all the research on my own, and I'm gonna watch a video here, and I listen to a person there and watch another video here, and then it's gonna be a chaos. Plus, it's just how it is. People don't really want to share the most, the good info for free. If you want to find the really good info, you're gonna have to pay for it. And another thing is that when you pay for something, you actually take it seriously, especially if it's big money. A course can cost a couple of $100 to, many thousands of dollars. And the more you're gonna pay, the more you're gonna feel like, at least I do. The more I feel like I'm gonna have to, do this and stick to this. Like, now it's serious. Because if I watch a video, I'm like, I'm not taking it too serious yet. But with a course, I will. So I have looked. There are many, many courses regarding Amazon, and I haven't decided yet for sure which one. And so in March, or maybe earlier, I've decided that I'm gonna start going through a course and kind of slowly building this whole thing up. And if anybody knows of any good course that they've either been through or they've heard of, please let me know in the comments below, because maybe I won't be able to find all the courses out there. I've made a list of some, but I'd really appreciate if you can share with me some course that you know of that's that can be very beneficial regarding FBA. So yeah, and then the last thing that I wanna talk about is the mindset, right? And because you can decide on something, you can go and find a course, but I've seen people that do these things and they still don't really move on forward, or they fail in little things, and then they're like, oh, I don't want to do this, and then they postpone, and then they forget about the whole business, and they just procrastinate. They don't want to do it because it sucks to fail, right? Who wants to fail? Well, the thing is that it's really important to have a really, strong mindset when you're getting yourself into all of this, because I know beforehand that there can be losses with this, right? Like, you can lose money, you can lose time and energy doing this, because this is not going to be easy, even though it's not like a business where you're located physically. It's still gonna, require you to think a lot if you really want to do it well. And there are going to be moments when you feel like you failed, and to overcome this, you have to be really strong in the mindset. And to get into this mindset, you have to really take it seriously. You have to understand, is this the thing that I'm really eager to do? Is this the thing that really will make me happy and interesting for me? And watch videos and people who are motivational. Like, I've talked about this before already. Read books that are, really motivational. If you feel like you're going down a little bit, being sad, watch more videos, read success stories, because just because you failed at something once, or is becoming difficult, doesn't mean you won't be able to succeed in the long run. Successful people are the ones that fail and start again over and over, and every time it becomes better because there's already certain experience that you have that you can kind of push off from. I was just talking with my friend the other day, and he said that imagine doing for 2 years something and then failing, and you've lost 2 years of your life. Well, I think it's possible. Yeah, you can do that if you if that's your weak mindset, then yeah, you can consider it like that. You've done something for 2 years and you failed. I don't think it's like that at all. I think you can use these 2 years, and you know, if you failed, you can use that experience to become stronger and, you know, do something with more, you know, wisdom the next time. So, like I've been saying, that there is no failure, there's feedback, and it's really important to have it here and to take it like that. If you fail, don't, you know, drop your hands down low and don't think that, okay, this is the end of the world. No, it's normal to fail in certain things. You won't be able to succeed all the time. It just doesn't work like that. So if you're also deciding to start a business, an online business, be excited, be eager to do it, but don't be blind and don't think that, oh, you know, I'm just gonna make money and everything is gonna be so easy and passive income. No, it's gonna be difficult, but it doesn't take away from the excitement, right? So mindset, very important. And I'm gonna, even though I know I've taken some time to think about this, and I know myself, I'm already hyped up about this, but I'm still gonna work on my mindset even more. And this is what I urge you to do also, if you're gonna start, you know, an online business, because who knows where it will take you. Maybe it can take you anywhere. You just have to try yourself in different things, right? Life should be interesting and different all the time. Otherwise, if you're just still, it becomes boring. At least I, like I said in the beginning, I just feel like I'm bored. I can't go to work and, you know, chill out the rest of the day and have boring weekends. No, I need to do something in order not to, you know, just be bored. So yeah, this was about it for the first video. I'm gonna once in a while post about the things that, you know, have been coming my way regarding this FBA business. I'm gonna share my experience, maybe things that I've learned, things that I failed at already that could be done better. And I'm gonna keep myself like this accountable, and hopefully this can interest you also. And I'm gonna write more detailed blog posts about this. I haven't written it yet, but I'll have it in the description for this video. So if you wanna learn more about my whole view on this and how I'm gonna, you know, proceed, what steps I'm gonna make, then you should definitely go over, read my blog. And like I said, I'm gonna keep making this kind of content once in a while. Should be interesting. I'm excited. And if you're starting a business, hop on with me and let's do it together. So yeah, if you liked it, please subscribe and visit my blog. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.